Welcome to Refresh. This is Pastor Kim Robinson. It's my desire that you listen, that you can experience blessed faith and creative life with this Kix Ministries and Victory Harvest Church podcast. Hi, this is Pastor Kim with the Refresh podcast. The title of this podcast is Expression. My opening scripture is something we've all heard before, but I hope this podcast refreshes this for you. It's Luke 1:37, "For with God nothing shall be impossible." He is the God of what we see as the impossible. He goes beyond our ability and he goes beyond what we see. He always does the impossible. He always sees the impossible. He always asks us to believe him for the impossible. Everyone faces the impossible, and how they deal with it is an expression of faith. As we believe in the one who does the impossible, we find the expression of who he is, his miracles, his wonders, his love, and his blessing. Everything God has promised and everything he does, all his impossibilities embrace his blessing. His blessing has always been toward us and has always been given to us. Adam and Eve walked away from it by believing something other than what God spoke to them. You see, the blessing of the Lord manifests impossibilities. His blessing speaks. His blessing is the expression of himself. His impossibilities, his promises, his love and goodness, and his word all have been revealed and expressed through seasons of time and are now spoken and expressed and sealed in each of us through Jesus. His blessing is seen and expressed through Jesus, through the word of God you read and speak, and his impossibilities and his word are revealed, fulfilled, and sealed by the work of Jesus Christ. He has always been the God of impossibilities, and he came to this earth to bring his impossibilities to each individual. He did this so that we may have a personal experience and an experience in a way that his personal expression in our lives of his goodness would be seen and experienced in us through Jesus Christ. See, Jesus Christ, his word, and the Holy Spirit's work in our lives is the pathway for personal impossibilities. In Hebrews 1:1-3, it says this, "God, who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, and he hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds." Well, let's look at the word worlds. This word worlds is the word ion. It means not only the world we live in, but the universe, the stars, the worlds that are in the universe. And it also means something so important for us to understand. It means time, eternity, forever, an unbroken age, a perpetuity of time, and importantly, a period of time and an age and a season. See, this word ion goes beyond the universe that we can imagine or think. It goes beyond the world we live in, and it goes beyond that to embrace all time that he has made. He has made time. He has made the ages. He has made the seasons. He has made eternity. Every moment, every minute, every second is a perpetuity of time, which means it's beyond limits of time. Time he has designed. He made the day, he made the night, and it goes beyond the limits of time. He made the sun, he made the moon, he designed the seasons, and they go beyond the limits of time. Time is the age and periods and moments that he has expressed himself in. Like Abraham as a friend of God, Adam and Eve in relationship with him in the garden, Esther for such a time as this, Mary's encounter with the angel and her response saying, "Be it done unto me according to thy word." Jesus' birth, the miracles of Jesus and the expression of God in the earth, all this going beyond the limits of time. And he's still moving today beyond the limits of time. And as he moved in the book of Acts, beyond the limits of time and his return. And again, as I've said it, every moment and every minute, every second is his perpetuity of time, which means it's beyond limits of time. See, every person before us in the Word is bringing his expression of truth. And you are an expression of him in this now time, with each moment revealing and making impossibilities possible, seasons and movements of magnificence made by him, given by him, and these are periods and ages of his defined times. They are unbroken ages, linked together by his person, by his word, by his spirit, by himself in Jesus, going beyond the limits of time. In him, we bypass every age of time, and every moment is seen by him and complete in him. These are all specific ages of time, specific seasons of time completed in him. He is always, always, always making impossibilities possible. And again, these seasons and times are defined by his design. Within these moments, we are either an expression of him or an expression of something else. As he is the brightness of his glory, he has bestowed this upon us. We are seated with him in heavenly places. With time, now surrendering to his promised possibilities, he is bypassing the natural and he is expressing his supernatural. Time has always surrendered to faith, for faith is now. As I said, in him we bypass every age of time, and every moment is seen by him and complete in him. And these are specific times, surrendering to the fulfillment of all things in him. As he said, it is finished. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the completed work of God for all time. It goes on to say in Hebrews 1 verse 3, that Jesus is the one who, being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, upholding all things by the word of his power, it says. His power is his word, and his word is the express image of himself. He upholds all things by the word of his power. Again, his power is holding his words. Let's look at it. How is he the express image of his person? The express image is a statement found in the word harachter. It means this. It means the exact expression and the exact image of any person or thing, marked by the exact likeness, that is the precise reproduction in every respect. No different. Engraved. Exact. Exactly the same. The express image. He is this expressed image of his person, of the person of God himself, the majesty on high. See, this word expression in the dictionary is defined as the process of making known one's thoughts or feelings, which would refer to make known one's likeness and who they are and their desires. So as Jesus is the expression of the Father, the Holy Spirit, and the Word, we see the desires, the will, and the life, and the love of God. We see his goodness. We see his expression in Jesus Christ. We see his uniqueness and his blessing for us to embrace. His word shows us the expression in every moment in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. It speaks of amazing life through the book of Genesis to the book of Revelation. In 2 Thessalonians 3:5, in the NLT version, it says this: may the Lord lead your hearts into full understanding and expression of the love of God and the patient endurance that comes from Christ. The Lord leads us into his full understanding, and he leads our hearts to also be the expression of the love of God. He leads us to the full expression that comes from Jesus and his anointing. In 1 John 4:12, in the NLT version, it says this: no one has ever seen God, but if we love each other, God lives in us and his love is brought to full expression in us. The love of God brought to full expression. As we love, the word of God tells us that his love is brought to this. His love produces and brings the full expression of God in our hearts and in our lives. Love has brought the impossibilities to us. Love has brought the expression of who he is. Love has brought the expression of his blessing. It is poured out upon us. His miracle working power is expression of his desires, who he is, and his love and goodness. The Bible tells us that you will know them by their fruit. And obviously, hate and meanness and lack of kindness and racism and supremacy and the likes are not the expression of him. And it does not produce the full expression, as 1 John 4:12 declares. The CSB version of Hebrews 1:3 says it like this: the Son is the radiance of God's glory and the exact expression of him. The Word tells us, as he is, so are we. He has made us in his likeness, and we bear the likeness of Jesus. We are the radiance of his glory. We are the expression of him. We are the radiance of impossibilities. We are the radiance of faith. And faith works through his expression of love. How are we this expression? Well, it says in Romans 6, verses 4 through 5, as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so, we also should walk in newness of life. And it goes on to say this, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection. Walk in the newness of his life. Walk in the newness of him. Walk in the newness of his word. We are the expression of his resurrection. We are the expression of the impossible. We are the expression of his manifestation. We are the expression of his blessing. We are the expression of his person. We are the expression of his miracles. We are the expression of his compassion. And we are the expression of his love. And he is the one who, being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, and is upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high. And God, who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, but now he is speaking to us in these last days by his Son, Jesus Christ, whom he has appointed heir of all things, by whom he has made the worlds. He has dominated time. He has brought the finished work of all time in the Son. He has brought you the impossibilities to be possible through Jesus Christ, who is the expression of who he is, because he is God in the flesh come to you. He's declared he makes the impossible possible, and he declares it so absolute and so complete in Jesus, that his finished time is now. It is now for you. So have the God kind of faith, for you live by the faith of the Son of God. Have faith in God and experience the expression of God that nothing is impossible. For with God, nothing shall be impossible for you. Father, I thank you that you have brought your expression in your word, and you have sealed and signed and delivered this expression in Jesus. And I thank you, Father, that you and the Holy Spirit and Jesus are one working in our lives, bringing the expression of your blessing and your goodness, and that we can experience the impossible because you are the God of impossibilities and you make all things possible. And we give you praise for it. And I pray those that hear this podcast, Lord, are refreshed and experience the experience of who you are, your faith in every way, and all that your word promises. And the blessing is theirs, and they receive it and take it and experience it with the awesome place of your magnificent possibility that you have made out of everything that's been impossible. And we declare it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Pastor Kim is not only a screenwriter, director, and producer, she writes children's books and other publications. If you're interested in more of her Kix Media from Kix Ministries, check out our family faith-based feature films, Pastor Kim's blogs, and our many children's books and publications at kixtv.com.